Hey, thanks for being a part of the conversation. Let's play it forward. Real people, real stories, the struggle to play it forward. Episode number 624 is with singer-songwriter Sarah Reeves.
Hi, Arrow.
Good morning, Sarah. How are you doing today?
Great. How are you?
Absolutely fantastic. I'm very excited to talk with you because after hearing More Than Enough, I wanted to hear what your speaking voice is. And the reason why is because I'm so into, you know, to create inside a studio is one thing, but to share a conversation, oh my God, that's where the true meaning and purpose is.
Aw, well, thank you. I hope you're not disappointed with my speaking voice.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Because I'll tell you what, when I heard those harmonies inside the song right away, it shot me back to my last time in the recording studio where the engineer was saying, no, no, we're not going the route of the harmonies. You do too many harmonies. Do you deal with that as well?
Oh, no, it's never too many harmonies. You have to kick me out of the studio because I will just keep playing and layering and layering. Vocals are my favorite thing, so I love a good harmony. And I think producers appreciate it too, so I don't think anyone's gotten tired of it recently, but maybe. They just didn't talk.
I love the idea that you like to layer your vocals because that's one of my favorite things to do inside the studio. Before I even go into an actual physical studio, I like to design my songs in the home studio so I have a great idea of what we're going to be doing in that big room.
Yes, that is very important to have a plan going in, for sure.
What is it like for you to be the Chris Stapleton of this modern age of music where you are writing so many songs for other people?
You know, it's my passion. I love songwriting. It's something that I've done since I was a young girl. And it's very therapeutic, and I love writing songs for myself, but even sitting with other artists as well, or just, you know, I write for TV and film as well, and just kind of telling someone else's story and helping them craft exactly what they want to say is something that is very fulfilling. And, you know, there's always a piece of me that I kind of leave with them too. And just like little things that I can relate to, obviously, that I throw myself in. But it's super fulfilling to be able to write songs and play music. It's such a gift. I'm very thankful for it.
I just wish more men would listen to lyrics like yours, because I think it would be a much different world if guys would get away from just listening to that bass beat or those drums and really get into the story that you present.
I appreciate that. Thank you for saying that. It's funny because this new song that I have has really brought in so many women, but every now and then I'll get men that are like, thank you for writing these songs. And I'm like, thank you for saying thank you. And thank you for listening because it's not just for women. It's for men as well. And so I appreciate you saying that.
Is there a formula that you follow, or do you just go by what the universe is giving to you in the moment?
No, there's no formula. It's different every time I approach songwriting. Sometimes it's just me having a conversation with someone and maybe they say something or their experience inspires me and I write something in my phone. I have a list of titles that sometimes I pull from. Sometimes really just in the mundane of life, I'll be cleaning or taking a shower. I'll be like, humming a melody and I'm like, oh, that's pretty cool. And so I'll record it in my voice memo and then that becomes kind of the song for the day. So it's really just moments like that. There's no set formula that I have. It's very random.
Don't you love that feeling though, when something is coming to you and you go, oh no, that's it. Oh no, I've got, and it's like, okay, how did it go again? And you really do. I mean, it's such a moment. And if there's anybody around you, they think we're weird.
Yeah. Well, luckily I live in Nashville and most of the people here are they're musicians. And so we all understand those moments. But yeah, there's definitely those moments where you're like, man, nothing is coming. And then all of a sudden it hits and you're like, that's it. And everyone's excited in the room. And there is no feeling like that for sure.
Do you remember the first time that you sat down to write a song? Because I was at my next door neighbor's house and we were on her piano and I'll never forget that moment because I really felt like that. It was like, oh my God, I'm not just that guy next door. She helped me write a song.
Aw, I do. I was 15 when I wrote my first song, and like I grew up playing piano ever since I was 5. My parents put me in piano lessons, and so I was always interested in music. But songwriting for me came at 15. I actually had a friend of mine that passed away suddenly, very unexpectedly, and I didn't know how to express myself. And I just remember sitting in my bedroom as a young teenager, and I sat at my piano and I had my pen and notebook, and I just began to write out my thoughts. And then I started singing it, playing this melody, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I guess I wrote my first song. And it was dedicated to my friend that passed away, and it really just like showed me, wow, this is like very healing and therapeutic at the same time, and it's something that I just continued to do.
So many people don't understand that about we who are creative, that when things tragic like that happen, that we go into this area that we know how we're going to work our way through it because we know the energy that we have through creativity allows us to heal.
Yeah, it really does. Music is such a powerful thing, you know, and I think even listening to music, so it's not always me
Right,
writing it.
right.
Sometimes it's just turning on my favorite songs, or I listen to like, you know, lately I've been super into just classical music, instrumental in scoring and movies, and it's just like, oh, this just makes me feel something so deep that words can't express, you know. So listening to it, writing it, making it, yeah, it's very healing.
Don't you love that touch with classical music that you can sit there and even though, you know, there are no lyrics, but your heart is still creating a song with that. You're going, ooh, I could do this. Ooh, I could do that.
Yes. Yeah, I've been super into production lately as well. So not just writing lyric and melody, but also making the music. And so I've been really getting into scoring and just buying a bunch of plugins and strings, and I've been kind of like nerdy with it. Just kind of going off by myself and listening and trying to catch something different, you know. And I feel like that's kind of the season I'm in right now, is not a ton of words, honestly. I've just been making the music and really just engulfing myself in that, and it's been awesome. I definitely want to do more of that in the future
Well,
as well.
especially inside the studio, a lot of people, if people have not been in a studio to watch a musician or someone creative bringing things together, I mean, you're taking nothing and you're making something. And I mean, are you in shock when it happens?
I probably should be. Actually, yes, sometimes I am. I'm like, it's funny. Every day I walk into a studio or into a songwriting session, and I'm like, is there anything left in me? Like, is something going to come out? Because I've been doing this for so many years, and it's like, how is something new going to come out today? You know? And then 9 times out of 10, it does. Sometimes it doesn't, and you're like, oh shoot, that was my worst fear, and you walk away with nothing. But then I get in these flows and in these like rhythms, and it's just like bam, bam, bam. The music is flowing, the creativity, lyrics, everything, and I'm like, all right, I'm just gonna like ride this wave. And yeah, it's definitely shocking in those moments, I guess, sometimes.
Doesn't that start with a cleared head and heart? I'm a defragger. I write every single day. I've got to be able to clear my mind, body, and soul so that creativity has room to come and grow.
Yeah, I love that you're a writer as well. Definitely need a clear mind, but also sometimes it comes out of frustration, or maybe there is something in me that's like rattled a little bit. And yes, it does take that space in my heart and in my brain, but sometimes I have to get it out, and that is a way for me to clear my mind, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it totally
So
does.
it's different every time. I can't explain it, but there's days where I wake up and I just automatically know like something beautiful is going to happen today, and I'm going to make this amazing song. And then there's days where I wake up and I just am like, I feel like I have nothing. No, I don't have anything. No, it's okay, you know, to just take breaks and rest. And that is equally as important as the very proactive moments in my life as well. It's just the recovery and the rest and just the being, you know. to make room for that space. Wow. So.
You have got to come back to this show anytime in the future. The door is always going to be open for you.
Aw, thank you. I appreciate that. You're very kind. We'll have to have more conversations when we have time about writing, because I'd love
Absolutely.
To hear more about your process.
Oh, you got my attention right now. Well, you be brilliant today, okay?
All right. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me, Arrow.